it's Holy Week. And just a few days ago, that started with Palm Sunday, the day when Jesus rode into town triumphantly, where literally people were hailing him as the king. They didn't even want him to touch the ground, and so they were laying palm fronds on the ground and throwing their robes and clothes on the ground so that he wouldn't even have to, not even his donkey would have to touch the ground. And in a few days, we're going to celebrate Easter. But today is Good Friday. Today is a day that is crucial in the Christian faith. If you're someone who believes in Jesus Christ, then today, it's a big day in what we believe are historical acts that took place over 2,000 years ago. You see, today is the day that ultimately Jesus paid the price for every one of us. His life was taken when he was hung up on a cross. And today is crucial. It's momentous. Ever since Jesus died and was raised back to life, this day has forever changed history. In fact, you may not even know it, but your birthday is tied to these historical events. The timeline that is created from history has been created from this date. Everything rises and falls on these crucial events. In fact, these events were such a big deal that the Apostle Paul wrote about them in his letter to the church in Corinth. Listen to what it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 and 4. It says, "I pass on to you what was most important and what had also been passed on to me. Christ died for our sins, just as the scriptures said. He was buried and he was raised from the dead on the third day, just as the scriptures said." See, Paul's telling this group of people in Corinth, this is the most important thing. It's the most important thing I could be writing to you about. And today, it's the most important thing that I could be talking to you about. It's the most important thing that you could be sharing with your family and your friends who don't yet know Jesus. It's the most important thing that Jesus died on a cross so that you and I could have a way to be reunited with God someday. Nothing else even comes close to what happened 2,020 years ago. Jesus was wrongfully convicted of crimes he never committed, and he was sentenced to death. He was beaten and teased and mocked. The Bible says literally until the soldiers were bored. That they beat him and teased him and mocked him so much they eventually got bored, and so they stopped. Ultimately, he was forced to walk up a hill, to carry his cross, and to be crucified on it. To hang there in pain and in anguish, to be tormented. On that cross, he endured more mocking, more teasing. He was spit upon. He was made fun of. This is what happened on Good Friday. And if you're anything like me, you're wondering, then why do we call this Good Friday? It doesn't seem like such a Good Friday. These weren't good events that happened on Good Friday. Well, it's because God is in the business of taking things that seem bad, taking things that even are bad, and turning them to good. In fact, Paul also wrote about this. He wrote about this in another letter to the Romans. And in Romans chapter 8, verse 28, listen to what he says. "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them." See, God is literally in the business of taking horrible, awful things and turning them into good things. And in this case, not just a good thing, but an amazing thing, an awesome thing, the best thing that could have ever happened. But it requires you and I, if we're going to truly believe that this was a Good Friday, it requires you and I to believe it, to accept it, to humble ourselves, and to choose to put our hope and our trust in our faith in these events. That Jesus did die on a cross, but that on the third day he rose again. He conquered death. He came back to life, and he created a way for all of humanity, if they will simply choose to believe in him, to be reunited with God someday. That when we pass on from this life into the next, that we'll get to spend eternity with God in heaven instead of separated from him. You see, these events that happened were game changers. They were the most important thing, like Paul mentioned. It was an event that didn't look so good. In fact, it looked pretty bleak. The disciples were freaking out, and God turned it into something good. I want to leave you with one final passage that Paul wrote that seems extra fitting, knowing what's going on in the world around us today. Here's what Paul wrote in Romans chapter 15, verse 13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's my prayer for you and I today, that you and I will find the hope and joy in the midst of all the circumstances that are going on around us, that you'll spend a little bit of time reading about this day that we call Good Friday. You can find it in your Bibles in Matthew chapter 27. I would encourage you to take 5 minutes and read it for yourself. Spend a few minutes thinking about all of the events that Jesus endured for you and I, for your family, for your friends, even for our enemies. That God loved us so much, he sent his son Jesus to die for us. But friends, it didn't stop there. We only have the hope that we have. We can only find the hope in this world when we choose to believe that it didn't end with a death, but that it resulted in a resurrection. In a few days, we're going to celebrate Easter, and that's the fact that Jesus rose from the dead. He came out of that tomb, and that he is alive and well today. So find hope and comfort and strength in joy today.